Mommies, this is Tanya Noor's mom. So I'm here to make my new video on the hospital bag checklist you actually need for your baby and yourself. So a lot of you pregnant moms have been asking me that what is actually required. We all know that the hospital does send in a list that you need to carry with you, but there are things which they don't say, or they say and they're extra and you really don't need them. So with my experience, first I think let's go with the baby bag checklist. So for the baby, I think you need, number one, around 5 to 6 onesies that are full body suits. You need around 3 sets of cap, socks and mittens. Then you need blankets, at least 2-3 blankets. Then you need swaddles, around 2-3-4 swaddles. You need diapers, newborn baby diapers. You need a diaper rash cream. So that's all that that was needed for Noor when she was born. Just these 6 things. I would suggest take like an extra of everything, because you never know. And don't worry about the baby wash or cream or whatever. I think the hospital does that in the beginning. All you need are good clothes, warm clothes, blankets, swaddles, diapers, basically everything to cover up your kid from top to bottom. And in case you're having a baby in the winters, then obviously you also need thermals, like little those tiny thermals. And you need probably a sweater or a jacket or like a full fleece onesie. I think that should be required for winter babies. Okay, now for mommies. This is a good one because I did not have a lot of things when I went to the hospital and I needed them. And since I delivered during the lockdown, I couldn't even go back or send anyone. Obviously I couldn't go back, but I couldn't send anyone home to get those. So yeah, what do you need? Number one, I would say, hospitals say that you need to get your own gowns, nursing gowns, etc., etc. But trust me, they keep you in their own gown that they give you. And you only need a dress to go back. And you can still keep 2 just in case. So you don't need a nursing gown. You can like get a cool chic dress from any of the nice usual brands, H&M, Zara. Something like this with a V-neck that you can use to nurse. You don't need to get those nighties, and just a simple, plain, nice looking dress that makes you feel like you're beautiful and you've just got something very pretty and beautiful in your life. So anything that makes you happy, but not those nighties. You really don't need them. You just keep 2 of those. You need your slippers for sure. You need your hair scrunchie. You need your toothbrush, toothpaste. You need your body wash. You don't really need your shampoo because there's so much happening that you don't remember to shampoo your hair. Just your body wash, slippers, your undergarments. Not so much because you're usually wearing disposable panties. Your undergarments. And then you need extra large pads. I bought those maternity pads, but they were so uncomfortable that I ended up using the usual Whisper Ultra Thin Triple XL, and those worked well. So you need those. Then you need disposable panties. The hospital sometimes gives them. You can also take them. So I ordered them from Amazon. A lot of them are available. The one I bought was, I think, Ultra Ease. You can find them on Amazon. Very comfortable, and in fact, they have like an inbuilt pad inside them, so that also works. You can just put like an ultra thin layer over it. You need a nipple butter. So hospitals don't tell you this, but you've never breastfed and suddenly you start breastfeeding and your nipples are sore, they're hurting, they're dry, cracked, and you don't know what to do. So yes, that's a must. I thankfully carried one. I took the mom and company nipple butter, and that is really nice and I would really recommend it. It's also a small tub and it's very easy to carry. So yeah, that you need a feeding pillow because you're not used to picking up the baby like this, and your arms and your shoulders they get so tired that you end up having spasms. So yes, a feeding pillow is a must. It might look like a big thing to carry, but you'll definitely use it. Yeah, then you need, some snacks to munch on. So once your one full day of liquid diet is over and you're free to eat anything, just carry whatever you like to eat. So my favorite was papaya, and I was missing it from the last 9 months. That's my favorite fruit. I eat one every day. So, you know, after that one day of liquid food, I called up my mom and told her that please arrange it somehow for me. And she had it sent over from the driver, and oh my god, I felt so nice. So yeah, anything, you know, that keeps you happy, it can be biscuits or chocolate, but anything that you can have it on the second day. You need your mobile phone to post photos and go live as a baby comes out and share your happiness with the world. You need your charging cable, a must. You can probably also keep your headphones with you, because what happens is that you have the whole day to yourself. Like with me, there were no visitors allowed, so I had the whole day to myself, and Nur was mostly sleeping, and I was half lying down, so I wanted to see the TV, but then Nur would wake up, so I had to plug in my headphones and just speak to my friends or watch some series, just chill out a little. And yeah, most importantly, another thing that no one tells you, you need either a heating pad or like a hot water bottle, because your back goes for a toss because you're so tired from all the pushing and laboring. And even if you have a C-sec, the spinal tap, the injection that they give you in the spinal cord, really takes your back away for a toss. And you know, because you're stuck like this and like this, this entire thing. So I had a very bad time the second day, and thankfully one nurse had a hot water bottle that saved me. So yeah, this is one thing that no one tells you, but you will really need that. And yeah, that's about it. Don't stress too much. You'll get mostly all the medical stuff there, and then just keep what I'm telling you. Nothing special, no 4-5 gowns, and you know, just keep like two dresses which have either buttons here or have like a crisscross opening for nursing. And that's it. Be happy in your pregnancy. Be calm. The worst is over. You're not locked down inside the house like I was. And trust me, it was so bad. I used to cry every day because I couldn't even go down for a walk. I know it's still unsafe, but at least everything is open now, and you have some space to breathe. But yeah, I can't be sure of that also, because the AQI is pretty bad these days. But yes, it's still better than those days. So yeah, just be happy and do what you like. Sleep as much as you can, because you're not being able to sleep after the baby is born. And enjoy. It'll all happen in a second, and you won't even realize it. Just be happy and stay calm, and everything will be fine. And you have a happy baby in your lap, and you'll be a very happy mommy. And then probably you can also start talking about your baby like I did, because I thought that was the only way I can, you know, save some memories for her to show her later in life that this is what I did for you. And I will gift her this Instagram account when she gets older. So thank you. Bye-bye. Keep writing, sending me more questions.